If you think it's tough being an older woman in Hollywood, you'd be right. Not only do the roles dry up, but you're expected to Botox yourself to the hilt or even go under the knife to keep those youthful looks.
So how does a 67-year-old actress who's never had plastic surgery survive in the business? And how does she end up on the cover of Playboy magazine?
I went to find out from the woman herself, Jane Seymour.
Ask Jane Seymour about being the oldest woman on the cover of Playboy, and she's as surprised as anyone.
Well, first of all, I just thought it was ridiculous that they asked. And then I thought, you know what? Just because you reach a certain age doesn't mean you're not still fully a woman. And because I don't do all the kind of plasticky thing, and because I do play women of my own age as well, I just thought this was maybe empowering for a couple of women out there.
She also posed for the magazine back in 1987. So which took more courage?
I would say that doing it in your 60s is definitely much scarier.
I wasn't actually going to go there because I always think it's a delicate subject. But you said, I don't do the plasticky thing, and you mentioned that, you know, I thought about going for a tummy tuck and I didn't. Has that been hard being in Hollywood and not doing that?
Well, you know, I look around my contemporaries and I think I'm the last of a dying breed of dinosaur. But I'm working all the time, so it must be working for me. I can show you, I've got all these wrinkles, they're all moving around here, you know, so if I have to be angry, mad, sad, or whatever it is, I have my equipment. I just can't understand why an actress would get rid of all of that.
Get down below, quickly.
From Bond girl to Dr. Quinn medicine woman, Jane Seymour's career has been one of glittering highs, but also some devastating lows.
I went through a terrible divorce just before I turned 40. I was married to what I considered the safest thing in the world, my accountant. After about 10 years of marriage, I discovered that not only had he been incredibly unfaithful, that he'd lost all my money and left me $9 million in the red with the lawsuits from every major bank, including the government. And of course, being a woman, being a mother, what you do is you just pick yourself right back out of that black hole and say, wait a minute, right now I've got to get the school lunch ready, I've got to get the kids to school, I probably should call my agent and ask if he can get me some work. So I did all of the above and I said to my agent, I need to work now. And he called all the different channels in America and said, Jane will do anything.
The anything turned out to be an offer to appear in a TV movie, a Western, about a woman doctor. The movie turned into 6 seasons of a hit series and earned Seymour a Golden Globe.
That must be a particularly special role for you, given what it meant to you to get back into work at that time.
It was a gift.
Another gift of late, some rather memorable comedy roles.
Call me Kitty Cat.
Okay, Kitty Cat, this feels borderline inappropriate.
I love playing comedy. When I did Wedding Crashers, no one thought of me as a comedian. But when I started out as an actress, I used to do comedy on stage in England a lot.
She's here to talk to Kiwi women, and she's using her experience as inspiration.
I love the fact that I was invited to be part of a conference where women are getting together and being very authentic and sharing their journey. And sharing how they were bold enough to step up to the plate and just say, hey, you know, I'm just getting on with it. And I think, you know, this is the year of the women, especially in America right now. And I think women are just empowered.
And it's a great story, particularly around her divorce and then picking herself up $9 million in the red, and then the Dr. Quinn medicine woman role, which was a huge role for her.
And no one expected it to be successful either. She was saying, you know, it was a Western, it had a woman as the lead, as a doctor. I mean, it was doomed to failure, she thought, but she signed up anyway, because as you heard, she'd do anything. And then it was this absolute success story.
Yeah. Just quickly, isn't it interesting, though, that we live in an age where someone who doesn't have plastic surgery, that's the unusual thing.
Mm. And yet, she clearly leads a very healthy lifestyle. She exercises a lot. But she's at 67. She does not look 67.
She's hot.
Married four times. She has a boyfriend.
Jeremy. She's hot.